The Great Poets, William McGonagall, read by Gregor Fisher. The Tay Bridge Disaster. Beautiful railway bridge of the silvery Tay, alas, I'm very sorry to say that 90 lives have been taken away on the last Sabbath day of 1879, which will be remembered for a very long time. 'Twas about 7 o'clock at night, and the wind it blew with all its might, and the rain came pouring down, and the dark clouds seemed to frown, and the demon of the air seemed to say, "I'll blow down the Bridge of Tay." When the train left Edinburgh, the passengers' hearts were light and felt no sorrow. But Boreas blew a terrific gale, which made their hearts for to quail, and many of the passengers with fear did say, "I hope God will send us safe across the Bridge of Tay." But when the train came near to Wormit Bay, Boreas he did loud and angry bray, and shook the central girders of the Bridge of Tay, on the last Sabbath day of 1879, which will be remembered for a very long time. So the train sped on with all its might, and Bonnie Dundee soon hove in sight, and the passengers' hearts felt light, thinking they would enjoy themselves on the new year with their friends at home they loved most dear, and wish them all a happy new year. So the train moved slowly along the Bridge of Tay until it was about midway. Then the central girders with a crash gave way, and down went the train and passengers into the Tay. The storm fiend did loudly bray, because 90 lives had been taken away on the last Sabbath day of 1879, which will be remembered for a very long time. As soon as the catastrophe came to be known, the alarm from mouth to mouth was blown, and the cry rang out all o'er the town, "Good heavens! The Tay Bridge is blown down!" And a passenger train from Edinburgh, which filled all the people's hearts with sorrow, and made them for to turn pale, because none of the passengers were saved to tell the tale. How the disaster happened on the last Sabbath day of 1879, which will be remembered for a very long time. It must have been an awful sight to witness in the dusky moonlight, while the storm fiend did laugh and angry did bray along the railway bridge of the Silvery Tay. Oh, ill-fated bridge of the Silvery Tay, I must now conclude my lay by telling the world, fearlessly, without the least dismay, that your central girders would not have given way, at least many sensible men do say, had they been supported on each side with buttresses. At least many sensible men confesses, for the stronger we our houses do build, the less chance we have of being killed. The famous Tay Whale. 'Twas in the month of December, and in the year 1883, that a monster whale came to Dundee, resolved for a few days to sport and play and devour the small fishes in the Silvery Tay. So the monster whale did sport and play among the innocent little fishes in the beautiful Tay, until he was seen by some men one day, and they resolved to catch him without delay. When it came to be known a whale was seen in the Tay, some men began to talk and to say, "We must try and catch this monster of a whale. So come on, brave boys, and never say fail." Then the people together in crowds did run, resolved to capture the whale and to have some fun. So small boats were launched on the Silvery Tay, while the monster of the deep did sport and play. Oh, it was a most fearful and beautiful sight to see it lashing the water with its tail all its might, and making the water ascend like a shower of hail with one lash of its ugly and mighty tail.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.